What can you find on the details page at the Fonius Solar Watt Pilot app? This is what we are going to show you in today's video. Please note that this video is being recorded with the Solar Watt Pilot app version 1.5.0, and of course all the settings that you are doing in the Solar Watt Pilot app you can reset by just resetting the Watt Pilot device to its factory settings. So let's have a look now on the Solar Watt Pilot app, what we can see here in the details page. So as you see, we are now here at the home page of the Solar Watt Pilot. We see here the charging page, and there you can instantly see the power of your Watt Pilot, which it is charging with. When you now click on the page details, you can see now here a little bubble chart that you can access the data of the current voltages and of course of the current powers that you're drawing from your PV system. Please note, this little bubble chart has nothing to do with the bubble chart that you find on Fonius Solar Web on our monitoring platform. With this bubble chart, you can see where the power is coming from that your car is being using at the moment. So as you can see here, the yellow bubble chart, the yellow bubble on top, this is the PV surplus energy coming down from the roof. So in our case, we now see here, we have 10.7 kilowatt coming from the PV system. On the left-hand side, the green bubble, this is the battery storage. So this is your local battery storage within your PV system. Whenever you're drawing energy from the PV battery, then here you can see the power that is coming from. So in our case, this is 5.2 kilowatts coming from the PV stationary battery system. Yeah, and then last but not least, the gray bubble, this is the power that you are drawing from the public grid, from DNO grid. In our case, this is 300 watts, so 0.3 kilowatts, coming from the public grid. So with this bubble chart, you have the overview where your energy is currently coming from, depending on how you're charging your electric vehicle. Yeah, down below in the details, you can now see here the point PV surplus available. So this is in this case 16.2 kilowatts available from your PV generator. So this will always show you how much energy is coming down from the PV generator, how much energy is being delivered by the Fonius inverter. Yeah, down below you see the point starting power level. And this means the level when the Watt Pilot will start the charging process. So this is by default set to 1.4 kilowatts. This is the minimum charging power that the electric vehicle needs to start the charging process. So in this case, when there is 1.4 kilowatt of surplus energy within the system, then the Watt Pilot will start the charging of the electric vehicle. Yeah, then down below you see the Watt Pilot power. This is 16.4 kilowatts. This is the power that is being charged into the electric vehicle. And then down below you also see your stationary PV battery system. And this is of course here PV battery SOC. So this is the state of charge of the stationary battery system. It is at 93%. So there you can instantly see what the state of charge of your battery system is. And then down below you see the threshold of 95%, and in this case this means that the charging of the Watt Pilot and the electric vehicle will start whenever your PV stationary battery system is at 95% state of charge. So these values, they can be alternated in the settings and under cost optimizations. There you can set these thresholds depending on your needs and your wishes. Yeah, and third, if you have a Fonius own pilot in the system for generating hot water, for example, then this will also display up here. And then for the own pilot, you always see the current hot water temperature in the hot water boiler. So this will be in degrees of Celsius. And then you will also see the threshold of the own pilot. So this means you can also set the threshold, let's name it 20 degrees of Celsius, and then the Watt Pilot will start the charging of the electric vehicle whenever your hot water boiler is at 20 degrees of Celsius. Yeah, last but not least, then you can see also the information about the Type 2 charging cable. So which charging cable is connected to the Watt Pilot, and as well the voltage and the current for each and every phase you can see here in the setup. Yeah, and last but not least, you can also see the power factor. So whenever your car is charging, you want to know the power factor of it, then you can see it instantly here, as well as the voltage and the current values of each and every phase. Yeah, so this is a detailed detailed overview about the values page, and I hope this is useful for you and your visualization needs.